piece of news that nobody was talking about. Shame on you, TFW 2005. I am shocked that this kind of like glazed over and you guys put it on your Toy Arc website instead. There was a whole bunch of Transformers diecast stuff by Jada, and we've talked about it in the past, but you know, we only knew about this and that, and they were going to be doing a G1 Prime in two different scales. Now we know a lot more, and it's exciting about what else is going to be coming. Jada is a diecast company, for people who didn't hear the past segment. It's a diecast company that usually relies on licenses of other famous vehicles throughout pop culture, whether it be anime, whether it be movies, whether it be television. I was familiar with Jada throughout the years because I was a big fan of Initial D, the manga and the anime. Mm-hmm. So when Jada brought all those cars over from Initial D, I bought all that stuff up, and it was just great to be able to pick up Initial D, you know, diecast on American soil and Canadian soil.
Mm-hmm.
Now that being said,
and we've brought up Jada before in the past during segments. Around this time with Toy Fair and Comic-Con and all that kind of stuff.
And they
too.
And by the way, they do top quality stuff. This is like really good quality stuff that they've done. They're a very good diecast company. This isn't like cheaper diecast that, you know, like Yatming and some of the more lower brand of 1x64 and 1x32 scale diecast cars. This is really good stuff. My father is a diecast car collector, so I vicariously lived through him and learned what was good and what was bad from when it comes to diecast. So there's a lot of Transformer stuff coming. And it was shown at Toy Fair, and it just kind of got glazed over because, and I could understand it. A lot of people were in the action figure section. They weren't really in the RC and diecast section of the convention. I know there was a guy who had a video that was walking around Toy Fair, and he was going to all the dead quiet areas, like mm-hmm. the board game areas and all the small indie companies.
Smart man.
And it was funny because I was watching his footage, and it's like those areas were dead. They were dead. It was like you were in like a small convention somewhere else. Aww. You know? And
it's a little bit sad. I like checking out the oddball stuff.
Well, like,
you know?
You had like the brain crane guys, you know, that like do all the board game stuff, and it's just like dead, and he's just walking around there and like, hi, how you doing, sir? So this is our latest board game. So I think that's what kind of happened. Everyone was just bum rushing all the movie properties, all the big pop culture stuff, that a lot of this stuff got ignored. So we have here, again, they show the Optimus Prime in the two different scales, the 1x64 scale, and I believe it's the 1x32 scale, I want to say. And that we knew for a while, and Jada has shown us that. They also teased us, and this is really cool. Like, this caught my attention, and I know that when I saw it, I'm like, oh, Jazdy's going to like this. Yeah. Mm-hmm. They're going to be doing a 1x24 scale and a 1x32 scale of both Jazz and G1 Jazz and G1 Trax.
It's happening. Yeah. It begins.
And just like their past 1x24 scale, what they do with their 1x24 scale stuff is they usually include either a coin, or if the character sometimes is associated with a driver or a figure, they usually include an action figure. Case in the Initial D stuff, all the Initial D stuff in 1x24 scale came with a figure of the driver. In the case of the Transformer stuff, because they are the driver, they'll include a coin here. And we've had that in the past where they did the Transformers The Last Night. They had a lot of the cars there from The Last Night, and it came with a coin if you saw them in Toys R Us and in Walmart. So Jazz, and this is really cool, like especially the Jazz one, because, you know, that Porsche Martini... Mm-hmm. You know, like, to even have the Martini logo still on it and everything, like, that is awesome.
Yeah. It's a lot of work. It's a lot of money.
That is going to be a sexy looking diecast.
It's a very iconic Porsche, a very, like, popular one, too, with
outside
those colors.
Outside of Transformers history, it's a very important car in Porsche's history. Like, that's the crazy thing about it. So it's something that is going to be really cool to own. With the Transformers emblem and the coin stuff. And same thing, hey, Trax, you know, if you're a Corvette fan, like, this is awesome. And I know a lot of people who are big fans of Corvettes and they love Trax. So to have them in these two scales, that's really cool. And on top of that, and that's just, like, from individual ones, they also showed here, it was a mock-up packaging of they're going to be doing these 1x64 scale in their Nano series. Their Nano series, which is for people that are probably a little bit familiar, what Jada does is they also have diecast standalone figures, And they usually do them based off of DC, Marvel. They did some WWE figures. They did Street Fighter at one point. They're usually, like, I want to say 1 to 2 inch die-cast figures. They're not posable. And they're painted, they're painted okay for the human characters and stuff that they're based on. So they're doing something similar to that in their nano metals die-cast scale. And they're doing smaller versions of, and I want to say these are, they're definitely not 1x64 scale. They're even smaller than that. But they're going to be doing a three-pack of G1 Volkswagen Bumblebee, G1 Optimus Prime, and G1 Sideswipe. So that's really cool. And it, this is part of Series 1, so it means that there's a possibility in the future there's going to be more three-packs of this. Of what characters, it really depends on what car brands they get the trademarks for. And that's kind of the cool thing, because when you're dealing with Hasbro making Transformer toys, they always have to worry about, oh, if we do the car like this, we have to pay the license to X car company. Like, if we do, you know, Prowl exactly how he's supposed to be, you know, Nissan's going to come knock and go, hey, that's our Datsun, you know? So we want a piece of that pie for the license. The thing is, with all these diecast companies, most of the time they already have, you know, these licenses. They already talked to Nissan. They already have, like, hey, we already are able to do this. I mean, again, looking at the Jazz, it already tells you, hey, they got Porsche. You know what I mean? The fact that, and again, Bumblebee there, Volkswagen and Porsche, they're kind of in the same bubble. You know, so
Volkswagen owns Porsche. They own Audi. They own Bugatti. They own Skoda, I think. They own quite a bit of companies out there.
Well, there you go. So
quite a bit.
And so what it pretty much leads to is that it kind of gives you already.
Oh, yeah, Lamborghini.
Well, there you go. So
it's like Audi owns Lamborghini, but so Audi's owned by Volkswagen.
Well, then that might even be able to tell us, because if they
own that, again, that's why we got the Lambor. Like, think about that.
That's why we got Sideswipe, exactly.
Exactly. So, like, think about that. That's how it's working. Now we have Bumblebee as the bug.
Yep. So it kind of gives us an idea of what we could expect in the future, considering what Jada has from a car licensing standpoint. And on the other side of it, they also showed a three-pack of the movie stuff. So we have Bumblebee in old Camaro, Bumblebee in the newer Camaro. I want to say this is the Camaro from, I want to say Age of Extinction. It looks like the Age of Extinction one. Correct me if I'm wrong, anyone. And then we have Optimus Prime in also his kind of Age of Extinction kind of look here too, like his second body. So... Mm-hmm.
Smaller ones you're talking about?
The smaller ones, triple pack?
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, the three pack.
I see it.
So so the way that I see it is that, I mean, there's probably more of this coming, which is really cool. I always dig this kind of stuff because, you know, if it's just a little small die-cast car, even a larger one, they put a lot more detail into it. And, I mean, this is really cool stuff. This is really cool stuff. And especially if you're a Generation 1 fan, I mean, to get a 1x24 scale Jazz, like, that is going to be one sexy hunk of metal. Because
exactly.
Because I own Jada's 1x32 stuff and 1x24 stuff of their Initial D stuff, and they look spectacular, interior and exterior. Like, they look amazing. So something like Jazz that has all that extra detail and the paint and everything, that's going to look really nice on someone's desk. You know, like, it's one of those times you don't have a choice for robot mode, but you'll be grateful to have a really nice, you know, alt mode to show off here. So with no, like, you know, transforming cuts on it, you know, to make the transformation.
Yeah.
So this is really cool. And again, they also teased, I forgot to mention this, they're also going to be doing a larger scale movie stuff too, a 1x32 and a 1x24 of Sideswipe from the movie. So there's going to also be large scale movie stuff too in the future from that side of it also. So a lot of cool stuff here from Jada. They always do amazing stuff. I mean, you could see already in the photos, the Optimus Prime, it looks really good. So they know what they're doing. They're a high quality company. They've yet to fail me. And again, while you're looking through this, if you Google it, they also right now, they're going to be doing Marvel stuff. They're going to be doing Knight Rider. They're going to be doing Ghostbusters. They're going to be doing Ninja Turtles. So there's a lot of other
Initial D again.
Yeah. The Initial D stuff, the one that they have on display looks very similar, to some of the stuff that I've picked up in the past with them. Although the larger Turano that's on display here has the pop-up headlights, which they didn't have originally. So that's going to be cool. So, and it comes with a different Takumi figure. It comes with the one from, season 4 or stage 4. So either way, 4th stage, excuse me. So this is all really awesome stuff. This looks really cool. Definitely check it out.